Hello, dear fans, friends, subscribers. Yes, I definitely have some problem with my throat here. But as I've always said on my cricket show, cricket is very, very dear to me. Doesn't matter what is the state of my health, I'm always there to talk on this cricket show. And who knows, maybe once after this cricket show, I might probably have nothing. So that is the intense passion that I have for this fantastic game of cricket. So let's start off or probably kick off this cricket happening show with the IPL matches. Today it was the 17th match and the 18th match of the IPL which was played. The first match was played between Delhi Daredevils and the Mumbai Indians. And let me tell you, 21 runs were required at the last over for the Mumbai Indians to win the match against the Delhi Daredevils. But there was a clash in the sense Rohit Sharma was there. And when Rohit Sharma is there, Morris was the bowler. He had already smoked Morris for a magnificent six. And then Hardik Pandya, who was been involved into a lot of, in fact, I would say, a sort of clashes with the fielders, then the batsmen, and he actually they ended up on same side of the wicket where they actually hit against each other. In the process, Rohit Sharma fell, and there fell the Mumbai hopes. As Rohit Sharma, once he was run out, he was absolutely he was well entrenched at the wicket, and when his wicket went away with 21 runs required, it was never going to be easy. I mean, Hardik Pandya was there, but the thing was to get the strike there, which he could not. And I'm sure that would have been the turning point in this game. Who knows? Probably Rohit Sharma could have probably spanked Chris Morris for 21 runs and taken the victory. But all in all, so this is what it is, an exciting match till the end. But then when Rohit Sharma fell with a clash with Hardik Pandya in the middle of the pitch, he could not, I mean, he was run out because of the because of him falling down. He was run out, and Rohit Sharma, while walking, was absolutely miffed. And why not? Hardik Pandya has to really, really improve on that particular phase of the game, I suppose. Well, and Mumbai Indians lost the match to the Delhi Daredevils by 10 runs. The next match that I'll be talking about is the 18th match of the IPL. Sunrisers Hyderabad took on the Delhi Daredevils. Kings XI Punjab took on the Sunrisers Hyderabad. Kings XI Punjab once again had their problems. The problem happens to be, and that is a big problem for them, The kingpins, again I've been repeating this on my cricket show, Miller and Maxwell are the pillars of this Kings XI Punjab batting. And if they don't fire, Kings XI Punjab are not getting anywhere. And that's there for all to see. Because they're probably averaging, let's see, how much did they make today? They made 10 runs between them. So that is probably 48 runs is what they have contributed in this IPL. And look at what Punjab, what has happened to Kings XI Punjab. They are languishing on the bottom of the table. They have just won one match in five games, and today was no different. Sunrisers Hyderabad won the match comfortably by five wickets. So first, let's go on to the 17th match, which was played between the Delhi Daredevils and Mumbai Indians. It was another exciting match that happened here at the Ferozshah Kotla in Delhi. So the toss was actually won by the Mumbai Indians captain Rohit Sharma, and he had no hesitation in putting the Delhi Daredevils into bat. Well, Quinton de Kock, who has been scoring so heavily in this Indian Premier League for a change today, was an early victim. In fact, Mitchell McLennan was the one who actually provided the breakthrough when Quinton de Kock holed up to Hardik Pandya for 9 of 7 balls with 2 fours. After that, Shreyas Iyer, who has been struggling a lot in this IPL, finally managed to reach double figures. In fact, he also showed some glimpses of his hitting, as he hit 1-4 and then followed it up with a beautiful six of the bowling of Mitchell McLenahan before Hardik Pandya actually picked him up by getting him caught by Ambati Raidu for 19 of 20 deliveries, 1-4 and 1-6. Sanju Samson was there at the crease. He was joined in by KK Nair, but KK Nair could not last long. He was dismissed very early. He was a victim of Harbhajan Singh for 5, and now it was left to Sanju Samson and JP Duminy to really resurrect things for Delhi Daredevils. And well, they were struggling 7 in the 8th over. They were 54 for 3. And then came the partnership, which was very, very essential. And it was a 69-run partnership. But definitely, it was something that Samson and Duminy had to stitch together. And they definitely switched that part. They stitched a partnership of 69 runs, which was very well done. Samson was also playing his strokes. As you know, he's a very good driver of the ball. At the other end, JP Duminy was also doing, and both were really playing some percentage cricket, because they knew that if at all Delhi Daredevils has to put a total on the board, these are the two batsmen who have to really take it till the end. And well, they definitely did it to that extent by taking the match, taking this innings till the 17th over, and suddenly we saw an explosion coming in from Duminy's bat. Duminy actually went on to hit Jasprit Bumrah for 2 sixes, and what shots they were. They were really, I would say, stupendous strokes from Duminy. Jasprit Bumrah was clattered for 2 sixes. As the partnership, as the score reached 125 in the 17th over, Mitchell McLenahan returned for his second spell and nipped up the wicket of Sanju Samson, but not before Sanju Samson made an impressive 60. Of 48 deliveries, 4 fours and 2 sixes, and then finally, as I said, it was left to JP Duminy to take them along. He took them along by spanking Jasprit Bumrah in the death overs for a lot of runs, as JP Duminy finished on an unbeaten 49 of 31 balls with 3 fours and 2 sixes, and then Pawan Negi finished on a 10 not out, and the score was 164 for 4, and one probably thought that the 164 was not going to be enough for the Delhi Daredevils against the Mumbai Indians. But things definitely, as I said, turned otherwise, as I would be narrating the tale for you of the Mumbai Indians inning shortly. Let's have a look at the bowling from the Mumbai Indians. Saudi, 3 overs, went for 21. Mitchell McLenahan, the wicket taker, 2 for 31 of his quota. Bumrah today looked listless, especially Duminy really going after him in a big way. 4 overs, no made, none for 42. Krunal Pandya. Now, Krunal Pandya has been, as I said, he is one who has already proved his mettle with the bat. He has proved his mettle with the ball. And he's only going from strength to strength. He's showing that he can be much more than Hardik Pandya, his brother. And what a day for Krunal Pandya. And he was the one who really, I would say, stemmed the flow of runs with 4 overs, no maiden, none for 25. Hardik Pandya bowled 1 of 1 for 7. Harbhajan Singh, 3 overs, 1 for 24. Keenan Pollard bowled 1 over, and 11 runs were taken off that over. Now, it was a turn for the Mumbai Indians to chase a total that was put up by Delhi Daredevils of 164. And let's have a look at what happened. Well, the start was not good at all. Parthiv Patel was brilliantly run out by Shreyas Iyer. Good piece of fielding from Shreyas Iyer, and a quick return into De Kock's gloves, and Parthiv Patel was a goner. Run out for 1. So not a good start for the Mumbai Indians. First up, Ambati Raidu came in and joined Rohit Sharma, and then suddenly there was some momentum. From 9 for 1, they gathered momentum. Both Rohit Sharma started hitting some boundaries. Ambati Raidu also started hitting some boundaries. And that was good to see. And while this was going on, the partnership had actually put on 53 runs for the second wicket in the 9th over. And things were looking in control at that stage when this was the turn of first. And then we also saw that Zahir Khan was bowling some very good yorkers to the batsmen. And then we saw the return of spin. Pawan Negi was spanked to the tune of 19 runs in the single over, and he never bowled after that. Chris Morris really put a sort of a control as he started hitting those lines very well, and also he was very, very perfect with his Yorkers. And then now was the real turning game, because they had two leg spinners, as you know, the Delhi Daredevils, and this was their big shot at the Mumbai Indians. And if at all they had to win this match with such a modest score, it could have only been done by the leg spinners. And yes, the leg spinners were the one who really turned it for them, with Amit Mishra once again unveiling his googlies, which Ambati Raidu could not read. And Ambati Raidu was a victim, bowled by Mishra of a googly for 25 of 23 balls and 4 fours. It was Krunal Pandya who came out, and Krunal Pandya gave a magnificent company to Rohit Sharma. And he really brought the run rate a notch, in the sense he came in, there was a real sense of urgency when Raidu left. And Krunal Pandya actually coming, I thought he was promoted to the batting order, and he was given clear instructions to go for the bowling. And I thought Krunal Pandya played a nice little innings. So he played an innings which was absolutely perfect for the game, as he really charged the bowlers and hit 36 runs of just 17 deliveries with 4 fours and 2 sixes, which was hit with lots of precision. And Pawan Negi had to really suffer. Krunal Pandya and Rohit Sharma then did a good job of pulling the score from 62. As I said, once Krunal Pandya came in, runs really cascaded in the 4 overs, where Krunal Pandya's contribution was 36 in that partnership, which will really tell you how quickly Krunal Pandya played. 36 of just 17 deliveries, 4 fours and 2 sixes. And then we saw Amit Mishra come in once again, and this time he picked up a very big wicket, and that was of Josh Butler, as Josh Butler knew nothing about a delivery from Amit Mishra. Again a googly, it was LW for 2, and then it was Rohit Sharma and Kieran Pollard. Now this was the time when 42 runs were required of 18 deliveries, 3 overs and 42 runs, and especially considering that Rohit Sharma was looking, as I said, very well entrenched at the crease, and Kieran Pollard on the other end, one would have probably never even thought that Mumbai Indians would lose. But Kieran Pollard, well, he did his bit, 19 of 18 balls. In fact, he allowed Rohit Sharma to hit the scoring. But the problem for the Mumbai Indians was that was the time we had Chris Morris firing in those pinpoint Yorkers, and also Zahir Khan doing a good job. First, the spinners did a good job, and then the pace bowlers. And then finally, it was Zahir Khan who picked up a big wicket, that of Kieran Pollard for 19 of just 18 deliveries, 1-6. And then it was Hardik Pandya. Now was the real taste of the game here. And finally, with Hardik Pandya at the other end and Rohit Sharma still there, Mumbai still had hope. 21 runs, both the players are capable, and Mumbai definitely had hope. And let's look at what happened. In fact, it was Rohit Sharma, 21 runs were required. Chris Morris was the bowler in the final over, and Chris Morris was spanked for a beautiful 6 by Rohit Sharma of the very first delivery. And things were going on, and then disaster struck in the third ball when Rohit Sharma actually collided with Hardik Pandya in mid-pitch while going for the run. And both of them, in fact, the force was such that Rohit Sharma slipped down the ground and he couldn't make it to the crease. And in the meanwhile, it was all over. Rohit Sharma was on his way back, run out of 65, 48 balls, 7 fours and 1-6. And he was absolutely fuming while walking there. And no doubt he knew that with Rohit Sharma gone, it was something which was going to be beyond the Mumbai Indians. But still there was hope, because Bhaji was walking in. And Harbhajan Singh, as you know, if he swings the bat, the ball really, really flies. But it was not the case. Morris was so good that he nipped Harbhajan Singh LBW of the fourth delivery. Hardik Pandya could never get to the other end. And finally, it was all over. Team Saadi was not out on 1. Pandya was not out on 2. And could you believe it? Mumbai Indians lost the match to the Delhi Daredevils by just 10 runs. And as I said, the turning point was the collision between Hardik Pandya and Rohit Sharma mid-pitch. And one does not know what is the reason. Yeah, in fact, Hardik Pandya also collided with Josh Butler in the field and now at a very crucial juncture. And I thought that was the turning point in the game. Now, as far as the bowling was concerned, Zahir Khan, 4 overs, 1 for 30, bowled well. Shami, 3 overs, none for 24, a bit costly. Pawan Negi, 1 overs, banked for 19. Chris Morris was the pick of the bowlers, 4 overs, 1 for 27. The spinners did a very good job. Amit Mishra, 4 overs, 2 for 24. Imran Tahir, bowling 4 overs, none for 29. And Sanju Samson of Delhi Daredevils took away the man of the match award. What a match we had here at Firozshah Kotla in Delhi. So that is Mumbai Indians losing the match to the Delhi Daredevils by 10 runs. Now let's get on to the second match. The second match is just played between King Salman Punjab and Sunrisers Hyderabad. The toss was actually won by the Sunrisers Hyderabad team, and they decided to insert King Salman Punjab into bat at the Rajiv Gandhi International Stadium Uppal in Hyderabad. Well, the start was not good for the King Salman Punjab. Bhuvaneshwar Kumar bowling a beautiful outswinger that Murali Vijay edged on, and Naman Oja behind stumps made no mistake. So he was gone for two of three balls. Manan Vora and Sean Marsh in the middle really started improving things for the King Salman Punjab, especially Manan Vora was coming out with his strokes with gay abandon, and one of the strokes that he hit was a real beauty as he smoked the Bhuvaneshwar Kumar over extra cover for a six. What a shot that was. Sean Marsh was also doing his bit. He was also doing a good job of hitting the boundaries and a few sixes in between. And Manan Vora and Marsh were doing well. And this was also definitely not needed for the King Salman Punjab, as Manan Vora, after playing a good innings of 25-23 balls with 3 fours and 1 6, was run out for 25. Sean Marsh contributed 40. Now, at this time, it was Bhuvaneshwar Kumar and Barinder Sran bowling. Barinder Sran and Bhuvaneshwar Kumar was a bit costly, but Mustafizur Rahman, once he was introduced into the attack, in fact, today he was the man of the match. What a spell of bowling for Mustafizur Rahman in a T20 match. If you are going to bowl 4 overs, 1 maiden, 9 runs and 2 wickets, this is absolutely fantastic stuff coming in from Mustafizur Rahman. Just, I would say, take a bow, Mr. Mustafizur Rahman. And he was the one who got the man of the match out. What a bowling. I mean, what variations. Cutters, Yorkers, you name it. Slower bouncers. He tried everything, and everything went off beautifully for him. As Sean Marsh made 40, he was LBW ball, Mustafizur Rahman 40. So this was Mustafizur Rahman actually putting a lot of frustration into the King Salman Punjab camp with his splendid bowling. And there was more pressure when David Miller and Maxwell were there. And Moises Enriquez actually picked up both the wickets in a single over. Now, as I said, for the King Salman Punjab, the problem area has been the David Miller and Maxwell not scoring. And that was the precise case today, as both David Miller and Maxwell were in fact dismissed within 10 runs of each other, with David Miller contributing 9 of 11 balls with 1-4, Maxwell out for 1 in the same order of 100 days, and that put extreme pressure on the King Salman Punjab, from where they could never recover, with only Sean Marsh making 42. Yes, Nayak was the new wicketkeeper batsman making his debut today in the IPL. Well, he did pretty well, because in fact he was under extreme pressure that he actually took charge, and all that he could do was contribute 22 runs of 28 balls with 1-4, and then it was left to King Salman Punjab batsman Akshar Patel to really take this King Salman Punjab to a decent total of 143 for 6, as Akshar Patel targeted by hitting 3 sixes. In fact, he went after Deepak Hooda and put him for sixes, and Akshar Patel was the one who favoured the long on and the mid-wicket region for getting all his 3 sixes and a single 4. In an unbeaten knock of 36 of 17